Okay, now let's see how the topography schedule works. Before doing that, I want to keep track of the names of different surfaces. For instance, if I click on the surface of the street, I want to change the name to EX for existing street because the streets are already there. So we need to change them to existing on the face as well. And it's not demolished, okay? So change the name and change the face to existing. I'm gonna apply that. Also, I want to select the surface of the topography, and it's also existing, and it should be renamed to X topo. Okay, so we can follow the items easily later. Okay, so existing topo, the face created is existing. I'm gonna apply that. There are some changes here, but that's totally okay. That's because the face filter is on show all. If we change it to show complete, you can see it as how it looks like when it's completed. Okay, and we have the building pad over there. That's all good. Also, this is the excavation due to the building pad, and this is in new construction, so that's okay. But I also need to change the name to let me see. I'm gonna name it as new, and I'm gonna name it as excavation, and I'm gonna add path, so it's because of the path. Okay, make sure to take care of the faces first. When you do that, then you can go to massing and site, and the option we need to use is graded region. So click on the graded region. It will ask you to select whether you want to create a new topo surface or another one that you start from scratch. I'll go with the first one. Create a new topo surface exactly like the existing one. Click once on the surface. So basically, it's gonna compare the existing and the construction in the two phases, and it's gonna give you the difference in the volume of the soil. Okay, you can just click on the finished surface. Here. So this is the graded region. The face created is new construction. I need to change the name to new topo. You can hit apply. And it will give us. Oh, did I change it? It did not. Okay, I'll get back and I'll change it to new. So if I click on the surface, this is the graded region that we created. I should change the name to new topo. Okay, apply. Now it's good. Now that we have all the phases correctly, we can go to the schedules under the View tab, schedules and quantities. You can type T. Topography schedule, very good. Now here we need the cut, the fill, the net cut fill. It's good to have face created and even face demolished to follow what's going on. Also, I'm gonna show you the difference between project area and surface area. Let me see. We can go with cut. Okay, seems about right. How about also, I want to have the name. That's important. I wanted to have the name at the top, so it's going to show at the left side of the schedule. And maybe we can follow by the cut, cut and fill, net cut and fill, and the rest is good. Okay. So as you can see here, there is no net cut fill due to the street surface or to the, I should take care of that. Actually, I should see, yeah, that's okay. So the new topo is causing 3 cubic meters of cut and close to 11 cubic meters of fill, and the net cut fill is about 7.5, right? So for instance, if 1 cubic meters of excavation would cost 100 bucks, then 7.5 would cost 750, right? So in this case, what we can do is actually we can move the building pad so the fill is lower and the cut is higher, so the net cut fill is a bit closer to zero. Okay. Also, usually when we talk about the area, what we mean is the actually projected area. As you can see, the surface area is bigger than projected area. Projected area is the area that we can see in an XY plane. And when we talk about the area of the site, the area of the building and everything, we usually mean projected area, not the surface area. Okay, so that's good to have in mind. Okay, maybe we can get rid of the current. It doesn't do anything good in here, but the rest are good information.